Hey everyone, I'm Sandhana, a student of the National Institute of Technology, Karnataka Surekkar, currently pursuing my second year in the branch of Electronics and Communication. Let me tell you a little bit about myself. I really enjoy reading Dan Brown novels, and my favorite book of his would be The Da Vinci Code. A quirk of mine is my fear of staircases. Today I'll be talking about IoT and the different communication technologies used in IoT. So let's get started. I'll first give you an example of one of the most recent and exciting developments in the field of IoT, nanosatellites. These satellites are basically just the sensing components with little or no extra material. These devices work in swarms to collect data and information. Some of these devices can be small enough to fit in the palm of your hand. There are many more developments in this field, such as driverless cars, smart homes, smart stores, edge computing, and so on. The list is just endless. Now let's understand what IoT is. The Internet of Things, or IoT, is a system of integrated computing devices, mechanical and digital machines with the ability to transfer data over a network without requiring human-to-human or human-to-computer interaction. To put it in simple words, it is a network of internet-connected objects able to collect and exchange data. Now, these devices that are in a network need some path or method to exchange data. This is where communication technologies and protocols come into picture. A communication protocol is basically a system of rules that allows two or more entities of communication system to transmit information. A protocol defines as rules, syntax, semantics, and synchronization of communication. Let me tell you a little bit about how I got interested in this topic. About a year ago, I was watching this TEDx talk on IoT. Back then, I didn't have much knowledge about it. The speaker spoke about how deeply IoT has been infused in our lives, using his everyday personal schedule as an example. I got really curious and wanted to know how this happens. I mean, these devices could not just be throwing around data through the air. There had to be some kind of technology it used, and I wanted to know about it. Let's go a little back in time and see how it all started. The main concept of a network of smart devices was discussed as early as 1982, with a modified Coca-Cola vending machine at the Carnegie Mellon University becoming the first internet-connected appliance able to report its inventory and whether newly loaded drinks were cold or not. In 1994, Reza Razi described the concept in IEEE spectrum as moving small packets of data to a large set of nodes so as to integrate and automate everything from home appliances to entire factories. Cisco Systems estimated that the IoT was born somewhere between 2008 and 2009, with the things-to-people ratio growing from 0.08 in 2003 to 1.84 in 2010. It is estimated that around 35 billion IoT devices would be connected worldwide by 2021. Now let's look into the basic concepts. Here we have the cloud, which stores data, the IoT devices, which are the main sources of data, and the web and mobile app, which can access these data for various purposes. This is the overall structure of how IoT works. Now, the basic protocols that are used in IoT. There are many more protocols used in IoT, but these are the basic ones. TCP/IP, it stands for Transmission Control Protocol, Internet Protocol. Using the internet, computers connect and communicate with one another, basically using this protocol. You can consider this as a book of rules, a step-by-step guide that each computer uses to know how to talk to another computer. MQTT, it stands for Message Queuing Telemetry Transport. MQTT and CoAP allow for communication from internet-based resource-rich devices to IoT-based resource-constrained devices. UDP, it stands for User Datagram Protocol. It is one of the oldest network protocols in existence, introduced in 1980. It is often used in applications that are specially tuned for real-time performance. Let's move on to the technologies used in IoT. These technologies are broadly classified into six major types. Let's look into each one in brief detail. Satellite communications enable cell phone communications from a phone to an extra antenna of about 10 to 15 miles and is useful for communication that utilizes low data volumes. These are called GSM, GPRS, 2G, 3G, 4G, and so on, based on connectivity speed. This form of communication is mostly referred to as M2M, that is machine to machine, because it allows devices such as a phone to send and receive data through the cell network. It provides stable connection and universal compatibility, but it has high monthly cost and high power consumption. Examples of satellite connectivity would be utility meters that send data to a remote server, or commercials updated on billboards. Next is radio frequency. Radio frequency communications are probably the easiest form of communications between devices. Protocols like ZigBee or Z-Wave use low-power RF radio embedded into electronic devices and systems. Due to low power consumption, its range is approximately 100 feet or 30 meters. The radio frequency band used in specific to its country. For example, the United States uses 908.4 MHz, while India uses 865.2 MHz. Example of RF would be your typical television remote, which uses radio frequency which enables you to switch channels. Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is a wireless local area network that works through 2.4 GHz UHF frequency. Wi-Fi provides internet access to devices that are within a range about 66 feet from the access point. Wi-Fi is useful in many IoT connections, but such connections typically connect to an external cloud server and are not directly connected to the smartphone. It has universal smartphone compatibility, is affordable, and is well protected and controlled, but it also uses a lot of power and has instability and inconsistency issues. Moving on, we have RFID. RFID stands for Radio Frequency Identification. It is a wireless use of electromagnetic fields to identify objects. Usually, you would install an active reader or reading tags that contain stored information. Short range RFID is about 10 cm, but long range can go up to 200 meters. It does not require power and is widely used technology, but is highly insecure and not compatible with smartphones. It runs on bands varying from 120 kHz to 928 MHz, depending on the range required and the region of usage. Examples would include factory data collection, road tolls, and building access. Next, we have Bluetooth. Bluetooth is a wireless technology standard for exchanging data over short distances. It uses 2.4 to 2.485 GHz band. Bluetooth exists in many products such as telephones, tablets, media players, and robotic systems. The technology is extremely useful when transferring information between two or more devices that are near each other in low bandwidth situations. Bluetooth protocols simplify the discovery and setup of services between devices. Then lastly, we have near field communication, or NFC. Near field communication uses electromagnetic induction between two loop antennas located within each other's near field, effectively forming an air core transformer. It operates within the globally available and unlicensed region, a radio frequency ISM band of 13.56 MHz, and at rates ranging from 106 kilobits per second to 424 kilobits per second. NFC involves an initiator and a target. The initiator actively generates an RF field that can power a passive target. This enables NFC targets to take very simple form factors such as tags, stickers, key fobs, or batteryless cards. It offers a low-speed connection with extremely simple setup. It can be used to bootstrap more capable wireless connections. I myself as well have worked in many IoT projects involving sensors, LLM measurements, and GSM communication models. You can start off with some simple projects that like dyes using LEDs and so on. It might seem difficult in the beginning, but once you get the hang of it, it becomes very interesting. I really hope this video is useful. If you want to get started with IoT, here are some references that you can use that might help you. With knowledge about IoT and little imagination, you can create wonders. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe and click on the bell button as to not miss out any content. Contact us here.